Okay, I want to talk about one more application problem. Again, in the context of this quotient rule, so we'll practice doing that. But this says, again, taken from our textbook, a producer and distributor of gift cards produces X boxes of cards per day at an average cost of, given by this cost function with the bar over it, meaning it's the average cost. 6x plus 8,000 in the numerator and 2x plus 300 in the denominator. If the producer is currently producing and distributing 280 boxes of cards each day, what change can she expect in the average daily cost of production if she increases production to 281 boxes? So this goes back to this idea of this marginal analysis where we say, okay, f of x is approximately, or f prime of x is approximately this f of x plus h minus f of x all over h, right? That's about what it is. I still have to take the limit for that to be actually technically equal, but for small h's, I get really close, right? The limits are really close. So f prime, when h is 1, like in this case, I really get f prime is approximately f of x plus 1 minus f of x over 1, which is the same thing as okay. So I really get kind of this approximation to the change in outputs, right? Those are my two outputs. F of x, like this would be in this particular problem, I'm talking about where I am now, 280. So this is maybe f of 280. And what happens when I get f of 281? What is the difference in that cost, right? For this particular cost function. Okay, so I want to use the derivative of this function to approximate that difference. Okay, so I'll just go down here and take the derivative. So again, let me just get a new piece of new full sheet. And here, this is my cost function. Average cost is equal to 6x plus 8,000 over 2x plus 300. And this, I again have to use the quotient rule. I have two things divided that I can't simplify or rearrange so that I can use another rule. So f of x is this 6x plus 8,000. F prime is 6. G of x, the denominator, is 2x plus 300. G prime of x is equal to 2x, or just 2, right? Okay, so these are both linear functions in the numerator and denominator. I expect that rate of change for them individually to be this line, to be just a constant rate of change. And now c prime, the average cost, or the derivative of the average cost, is given by this g f prime minus f g prime over g squared. So I'll go ahead and plug in these pieces that I have. G is 2x plus 300, and f prime is 6 minus 6x plus 8,000 times 2 over g squared, 2x plus 300 squared. So let's go ahead and simplify this numerator. Here I get 12x plus 1800 minus, and then I have 12x plus 16,000, but I'll leave the denominator as is, 2x plus 300 quantity squared. And then distribute this minus sign, minus 12x and minus 16,000. Over 2x plus 300 squared. So the 12x's cancel out, but I have 1800 minus 16,000. So I get negative 14,200 over 2x plus 300. And that's still squared. Okay, and then I'm interested in what happens. So, and this is just average cost, the derivative of average cost. And I want to know what's happening at C prime of 280. So I'll plug that in. Average cost at 280 boxes. Negative 14,200 over 2 times 280 plus 300 squared. Okay, so let me get what the denominator is. And I get, for the denominator, 739,600. Okay, so let me put that into my calculator, and I get, negative 0.0192. So this is some monetary amount, right? You'll see about a 2%, 2 cent decrease. She will see about a 2 cent decrease in average cost per unit by increasing production. Okay, let me know if you have questions.